Hi everyone, my name is Sunny Ho. I am very honored to be invited to speak to all of you regarding the non-resident speculation tax today.
Priscilla. 海外的人士呢，在购买大多伦多地区的房产的时候呢，要支付15%的海外买家税，那这个大家都清楚了。可是呢，这个规定呀，对很多国内人士要在大多伦多地区置业呢，还是产生了不小的困扰。那今天呢，我非常荣幸地请到了资深的房地产律师桑尼霍先生，来为大家对 NRST 海外买家税做一个解读，对大家特别关心的几个问题呢，来进行答疑。
My main practice in Ontario is primarily real estate law, corporate and commercial law, wills and estate law. So I am very thrilled and excited to speak with you today regarding the non-resident speculation tax. By the way, my Mandarin is very bad, so I will be conversing with Priscilla in English today, if that's okay.
So our first question would be, who actually needs to pay NRST, and at what time people need to pay?
Well, basically, the Ontario government started this new rule or policy in April of 2017. People or entities who are foreign nationals, and foreign nationals, there's definition. So let's say if you are not a Canadian citizen, or if you are not a permanent resident of Canada, or you are not a Canadian corporation, when you are buying a residential property in the Greater Golden Horseshoe area, which is pretty much the area close to Toronto, you will have to pay that 15% non-resident speculation tax.
Okay, and at what time?
Usually, non-resident speculation tax is being paid at the time of closing of the transaction. And this tax is in addition to the land transfer tax that everyone has to pay.
So when you say closing, so if I buy, for example, pre-construction condo, so do I pay at the time when I sign the contract, or do I pay when the building is finished and I close?
Yeah, so when you sign a contract with a builder, you don't pay any taxes.
Okay.
You only pay taxes to the Ontario government when registration is ready to occur, or when registration is actually occur or completed. At that point in time, you have the ownership or title of the property. And that's the time when you pay that 15% land transfer tax or non-speculation tax.
Perfect. So does that mean, so for example, I buy a new pre-construction condo, so I sign the contract now, so the time when I need to pay NRST would be like a 2, 3, 4 years down the road when the pre-construction building finished.
Right, right. At the time you take title of the ownership of the property.
Thank you. Very clear now. Okay, so the next question would be, Sunny, who are actually exempt to pay the non-resident speculation tax?
Yeah, so the rules also provide a few exemptions. So people who are normally under the Ontario Immigrant Nominee Program. So even though they may not be a Canadian citizen or permanent resident of Canada at the time of purchase, as long as they are under that program as a nominee, and they will be applying for permanent resident status in Canada, so they will not need to pay the NRST. So that's the first exemption.
Okay.
The second exemption is foreign national who is under the Refugee Protection Program.
Okay.
At the same time, if they're under that protection program, at the time of purchase, they won't need to pay the NRST.
Mm-hmm.
Now, the last exemption, which is fairly interesting exemption, which is a spouse of a Canadian citizen, a spouse who is a foreign national, but she or he is married or under the definition of a spouse, is a spouse of a Canadian citizen. So the Canadian citizen purchasing a real property with a foreign national, this foreign national is a spouse of the Canadian citizen or permanent resident of Canada, then this transaction is not subject to NRST. So no 15% tax is payable.
Oh, okay. Yeah. So in a way, if a Chinese married a Canadian, so then they together they purchased, let's say, detached house. So this detached house would be exempt for the NRST.
Right, right. But this house, like they have to move in and use that house as their principal place of residence, right?
Okay.
And they have to use it as principal place of residence. Otherwise, if it's only for investment purposes, it will not be exempted.
Very clear. Thank you. So now we're clear who are exempt to pay NRST. We also want to know who are eligible for the NRST rebate.
Okay, so there's also a rebate program. So rebate means that at the time of purchase or at the time you become the owner, you pay the 15% NRST. You pay first. But if you achieve some of the requirements set out by the Ontario government, then you will be able to make an application to apply for an application of the return of the 15% that you paid before.
So the first
rebate opportunity is for foreign national who bought the property, pay 15% NRST, but the foreign national becomes a permanent resident of Canada within 4 years after he purchased or she purchased, then this person will be able to make an application for a rebate of the 15% that he or she paid at the time of closing.
Right.
The other possibility for rebate is foreign students. Students who come to Canada and purchase a property, as long as that property is, number one, the student has to be a full-time student enrolling into an approved institution. Primarily, the definition of approved institution is post-secondary education. And I would think they would be, campus has to be in Ontario. And at the same time, if this person paid 15% at the time of purchase, and then this student will enroll in college or university full-time for 2 years after the purchase, then the student is eligible to make an application for the rebate.
Okay.
Right.
Well, there's one thing very interesting you mentioned. It says this, the school they go to has to be within Ontario.
Yes.
So does that mean, for example, if I go to University of Western Ontario, which is located in London, does that mean I'm still eligible for the rebate?
I would believe so, but since you bring up the topic of London, Ontario, it's interesting because the Greater Golden Horseshoe region does not include London.
Okay.
So what it means is if you're a foreign national, if you're purchasing a residential property in London, Ontario, you don't need to pay that
15% anyway,
because you don't fall within the region.
Okay. So but if this university student who goes to University of Western Ontario, but he or she want to purchase a condo in Toronto, in that way...
So that may be a little bit of a stretch because you have to use the property as your principal place of residence, right? So if your campus is 2 hours away from your condo, it would be fairly difficult for you to argue,
justify
that, the fact that you have to commute every day for 2 hours back and forth, 4 hours, right?
Okay.
So I think it has to make sense, right? Well, Priscilla, there's another category of people who will be eligible for the rebate, and that is foreign workers. So basically, these are the people who bought a property, paid a 15% NRST, but at the time they paid, they actually have a legal, valid work permit for them to work in Canada or in Ontario, right? So as long as they work as a full-time basis for at least a 1 year period of time, they will also be able to make an application to apply for the rebate.
Oh, okay. Sunny, there's a separate topic about the HST housing rebate.
Mm-hmm.
So when we get a new construction condo, if it's not for our own residential usage, normally the buyer is subject to pay the part of the HST.
Right.
So can you explain a little bit on that?
Yeah, so if you're buying a pre-construction property from a builder, most often than not, if you're buying it only for investment purposes, most of the agreement of purchase and sale requires you to pay a portion of HST, we call HST rebate.
Mm-hmm.
So HST rebate can be in the amount between $24,000 to $27,000 or less, depending on the purchase price.
Mm-hmm.
But the federal government actually provides you with an opportunity to make an application to get the rebate back, or the money that you pay to get it back. So they encourage you to invest they encourage you for long-term investment. So if you're an investor, you purchase the pre-construction property, you pay $24,000, let's say, at the time of closing, and then if you can get a lease for at least a one-year term with a tenant, so you lease the property out for at least a one-year term, you are entitled to make an application to apply for the return of the money, $24,000 that you paid at the time of closing.
Okay, so you just mentioned you need to have a one-year lease.
Yeah.
So that does that mean I don't actually need to wait for the end of the 1 year as long as I have the lease?
You are totally correct. Yeah, you're totally correct. As long as you sign a lease with a tenant, you are entitled to make an application immediately.
Right away. Okay.
You have to be careful at the same time because, and I explain that to my client all the time, the government encourages long-term investment. So what it means is, you can make an application, but even if you get the money back, don't sell it within that first year.
Oh,
because
okay.
if you sell it within that first year, even though you got the money back from the government, they have the right to take the money back from you.
Okay.
Because it has to be long-term investment.
Okay. Oh, this is a very important remark. Not everyone knows that.
That's
so we
right.
have to pay attention. We need to hold it long enough to lease it out, long enough to fully entitle for the rebate.
Even though you get the money back, you should still hold it. Because, because if the government finds out that as soon as you get the money back, you sold your property, they do have the right to come back and claw back the money that they gave you.
Okay, very clear now. So this will be the end of today's video. Thanks for watching. So if you have any real estate related questions, please subscribe to my channel and I'll be more than happy to answer your questions. And if you have any legal, real estate related legal questions, you're welcome to reach out to Sunny.
Yeah, and if you have any issue or concerns or questions that you may want to find out, you can email to our email general email address at info@ sunnyholawoffice.com, sunnyholawoffice.com. Someone should be replying your email.
Thank you, Sunny.
Yep, you're welcome.
Bye-bye.